நீயில்லாத நாளல்ல நாளாகுமா நீயில்லாத வாழ்வல்ல வாழ்வாகுமா
Book of James chapter 4 verse 6 But he gives us more grace. That is why scripture says, God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble. God opposes the proud. Yes, pride is a sin that God strongly opposes. He hates it and the God Almighty himself opposes. How can mere human rebel against and live? Such wicked is the sin of pride. In this world, if you can call anything as the first sin, it is the pride. In Isaiah chapter 14 verse 14, we can read that Lucifer exalted himself above God by saying, I will ascend above the tops of the clouds. I will make myself like the Most High. But God sent him to hell. We boast about our spiritual life and the worldly life. We take pride and boast about the spiritual gifts we have. We at times take too much pride in the talents and grace God has given. That's spiritual pride. When God uses us little in the ministry, that's it. We lose sight of who we are and our place. Pride strikes. Talents and gifts could be reasons to fall into pride. When someone can sing well, they tend to start looking down on people after some time. Remember, when someone preaches well or has prophetic anointing or possesses any God-given grace, it should be used humbly. It should not be the reason to feel proud about yourself. We should be grounded. If we keep humbling ourselves, then the Lord will keep pouring grace upon grace on us. Some of us lose our ministry, and for some, God doesn't use because of the pride that seeps in at the very early stage of ministry itself, and we end up losing everything. So be careful about the spiritual gifts God has given and use it humbly. We boast about the worldly things every day. It may be house, property, designation, looks, education, fame, and influence. It could be many things, but just like Paul said, consider all those as loss and garbage and humble yourself. Also, when Jesus rode the donkey in Jerusalem, everybody shouted, Hosanna! Hosanna! To whom was that for? For the donkey? To whom was the cloth for? Donkey? No, it was for the king who rode the donkey. We are all donkeys, so the praises we get are not ours. The clocks are not for us, but for Jesus, our King who is upon us. If you're mindful of that, no one can stop your growth and upliftment. As long as this humbleness rests within you, grace will keep increasing. No one can stop your success. God will use you mightily. Whatever we do will be victorious. You will be a royal diadem in the hand of your God. You will be a signet of perfection. God will do great and mighty things through you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God bless you.